Hello and welcome to Eclectic Classes. This is the fourth lesson in Ethernet tutorial series. Hope you have already gone through my previous videos on Ethernet. You can also go through my other videos on different industrial communication protocols. Now, let's start with today's lesson in which we will study about Ethernet twisted pair cable termination. All the wires in an Ethernet cable are assigned with a specific purpose. Ethernet and fast Ethernet uses two wires for transmit and two wires for receive functions. Here, as shown in the first figure, if we directly connect the two transmit pins of both the host or computer together and two receive pins of both the host or computer, then communication will not happen as transmitted data won't be received by the second host or computer anytime. Now, refer to the second figure. To make communication possible, transmit pins of first host or computer is connected to the receive pins of second one, and receive pins of first host or computer is connected to the transmit pins of second one. So, crossing over of pins is necessary for making communication successful. Just now, we understood that why the crossing over is necessary for communication. This crossing over could be implemented either by cable or an intermediary device such as hub or switch. In an Ethernet network, various types of devices are connected like computer, hub, switches, etc. All these devices have a network interface. The network interface interfaces with the connecting cable and receives the transmitted signal over the network. This network interface could be of two types: medium dependent interface MDI or medium dependent interface with crossover MDIX. To understand the difference between the two types of port, just go through the pinout diagram of the two types of port as shown here. You can see that in case of MDI port, transmit pins are 1 and 2 while receive pins are 3 and 6. Whereas in case of MDIX port, transmit pins are 3 and 6 while receive pins are 1 and 2. So here you see in case of MDIX port, the transmit and receive pins are interchanged. As we are clear now about the pin assignment of the two types of port, we can easily select which kind of cable, either straight through cable or crossover cable, to be used for connecting different devices. If we are planning to connect a computer to another computer, both will have MDI port, as PC NIC card supports MDI ports. So both side cards transmit pins will be 1 and 2, while both side receive pins will be 3 and 6. Now, if we use a straight through cable, that is connect pins 1 to 8 sequentially one side to another side, communication won't happen. We need to use crossover cable, that is wires from pin 1 and 2 of one side will be connected to pins 3 and 6 of another side. This way, we will be able to make communication possible. Now, if we are planning to connect a PC to a switch or a hub, we can connect these two through a straight through cable, that is pin 1 to 1, 2 to 2 and so on till pin 8 to 8. A PC has MDI port normally, while a switch or hub used to have a MDIX port normally. As MDI port has transmit pins at 1 and 2, while MDIX port has receive pins at pin 1 and 2, straight through cable will establish the communication. Nowadays, a new type of port is in use, auto MDIX. This type of port can switch over between MDI and MDIX configuration as per the requirement. So, as long as one side is auto MDIX, it does not matter we use a straight through cable or a crossover cable. It will ensure communication by auto configuration of the port as MDI or MDIX. This table summarizes which type of cable is used in which type of situation. If we need to connect MDI to MDI or MDIX to MDIX, that is similar port on both sides. A crossover cable will be needed. If we want to connect MDI to MDIX port, straight through cable will be required. And as long as one side has auto MDIX port, any kind of cable will be sufficient for communication. This was all about this session. I have tried my level best to explain you about Ethernet. Hope you like the video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications of my new videos. And if you like my video, please press the like button and share your views about this video. Thank you.